Among the men, Joe Joseph of Detroit battled to the wire with Carter, but at the finish, Carter had the percentage points. The $7,500 first prize, the big trophy, and the world's invitational match game bowling crown for 1961. So in bowling, it's Queen Marion and King Don. There's a story locally making the rounds of a woman who got a divorce today from her husband for the following reasons. He ordered her to drink powdered milk and eat Oleo while he had whole milk and butter. He expected $25 worth of groceries to last 6 weeks. He warned her not to drink any of his milk or eat any of his butter. He also dragged her out of bed and forced her to sleep on a couch. He used her money to buy an airplane and then take flying lessons. Mrs. Phyllis Davies is the lady's name. She left her husband on four occasions. She told the judge that she went back because he promised to make things better. Judge Frederick Weir asked her if things got better. No, she replied. In effect, he told me to cheer up. Things could be worse, so I cheered up and things sure got worse. The judge granted the divorce. Well, that's about the kind of a day it's been today. Eleanor Schano coming up right now with a weather report. And now on behalf of Ray Scott and myself, thanks very much for letting us visit and good night all.
Channel 4 brings you Pittsburgh's complete evening news and sports roundup each night at 7 o'clock on 4 Star News.
And this is Eleanor Schano speaking with the latest weather report and forecast. And if this is autumn, what can winter possibly bring when it arrives officially next week? Comes as no big news, I'm sure, but this has been the coldest December 13th in history. Temperatures plummeted to below the zero mark early this morning, breaking all previous records. This high pressure system that you see on the map is the villain. It's going to continue to influence our weather for the next 12 to 24 hours. But believe it or not, we have a warm front on the map, and it also will influence our weather eventually. Be back to tell you when and how in just a minute. But first, you know, the holiday season is here, and I'm sure that you all have someone special that you want to remember at Christmas time. And I think I have the perfect answer. I want you to pay particular attention to this message. Why don't you give the gift that will keep on giving every day of the year? Promise a princess.
Light up the season for someone you love.
And this Christmas, promise a princess. The small princess phone that takes up so little space and lights up for easy dialing in the dark. The princess is just the right Christmas greeting for any member of your family. In a bedroom, for instance, it fits snugly on a bedside table. It's an ideal extension in the den or family room, too. A space-saving convenience whenever you need it. And all through the year, the princess will help make the busiest days seem less hectic. This Christmas, promise a princess phone to someone in your family. Since you'll probably want it installed at a convenient time after the holidays, you can get this personal certificate to put on your tree. A princess phone for Christmas. Just call or drop in at your Bell Telephone business office and place your holiday order, or ask your telephone man.
Well, if you got up this morning and discovered that your car wouldn't start, you weren't alone. The AAA's reported more service calls this morning than any other day in history. The reason, a very obvious one. The temperature dropped to 1 below 0 overnight in Pittsburgh. The high this afternoon, even with all that sunshine, barely made it to 18. Present airport temperature is now 13, the relative humidity 66%. The wind is coming from the southwest tonight at 15 miles an hour, the barometer 30.2 inches. And the forecast? Oh, it's not going to be as cold tonight. As a matter of fact, it's going to be 6 degrees warmer. Skies will be clear, and our overnight low here in Pittsburgh, 5 above 0. To the north and east of us, temperatures will be down near or below the zero mark again. Now, tomorrow we'll have partly cloudy skies, continued cold temperatures, although again, not quite as cold as today. We're expecting a high of 30 degrees, and the forecasters say continued moderation for the remainder of the week. That's the story on the weather for tonight. I know that many of you are in the process of addressing Christmas cards, and here's one last helpful reminder from the Bell Telephone Company. There's a postal zone map in the front of the Pittsburgh Yellow Pages. Now, this can help speed the delivery of local mail. Be sure to use it, especially now during the pre-Christmas rush. Well, this is Eleanor Schano speaking. I hope that you have a very pleasant Wednesday. Join me again tomorrow night, immediately following 4-Star News. And now we invite you to stay tuned and take 4 with Dave Murray. Good night.
The latest up-to-the-minute weather report and forecast has been brought to you by the Bell Telephone Company of Pennsylvania.
your neighbors, enlarging your world through service and science.
Look, now there's a new look to new Pink Lotion Lux Liquid. You just snip the cap of this new plastic bottle. And how's this for convenience? One good healthy squeeze fills your dishpan with powerful suds. Yes, there's pink mildness through it, more power to it.
Watch. These two dishes are smeared with liquid cooking fats. Then put in tanks of dishwater, one containing a well-known clear liquid, the other Pink Lotion Lux Liquid. See the rich Lux Liquid suds cut through the greasy film right away. Rich Lux Liquid suds go to work faster, cut grease easier, get dishes sparkling clean.
And Pink Lotion Lux Liquid has world-famous Lux mildness. It leaves your hands lotion lovely.
Get Pink Lotion Lux Liquid in the new plastic squeeze bottle. There's pink mildness through it, more power to it.
Tonight, close up on a project that's on the verge of becoming the reality of Pittsburgh progress or a community black eye, the new Civic Arena. When we toured the uncompleted structure today, it was a pretty cold and lonely spot.
This is the new Civic Arena, the pride of Pittsburgh in the Lower Hill District. For over 2 weeks now, it's just been sitting out here in the cold. A labor dispute has stopped work on the project.
Some 300 skilled workers are off the job. They've stopped work with the approval of the Building Trades Council. The issue has nothing to do with the construction work on the arena. It's not a jurisdictional dispute. It's a dispute over who will maintain the arena when it's completed. The arena is scheduled to open in June. More than any other single project, the new arena has become the symbol of Pittsburgh progress. It's the keystone of the entire Lower Hill redevelopment program. The auditorium has received nationwide, even worldwide, publicity. Some of the country's foremost architects, builders, and city planners have toured this site. All of them have applauded the giant step the city is taking in the construction of the arena. The dome, covered with 4 acres of stainless steel, as you know, when completed, it will be the largest retractable dome in the world. The president of the Building Trades Council, Anthony Ferlin, told us today that the council will meet tomorrow to decide whether to remain out or go back on the job. Ferlin also said that it's become the practice on major jobs across the country that groups of unions building the building get the maintenance work. The Auditorium Authority, on the other hand, says it doesn't feel it can promise any group maintenance rights to any building before it's completed. That such an action could be in violation of the new Landrum-Griffin labor law. And a Point Breeze attorney, Mr. Howard Scott, who says he is acting as a private citizen, has filed charges against the 8 unions involved with the National Labor Relations Board. He called the work stoppage an unfair labor practice. The Civic Light Opera, which has been operating temporarily in a tent, is due to be the arena's first tenant this summer. A prolonged work stoppage could push the opening date back. Pittsburgh, unfortunately, around the country, has a reputation as a strike-happy town. The failure to complete the arena on time could be a real black eye for the city. Now, here's the way the auditorium is going to look in June. A symbol of progress Pittsburgh can hold up to the world. We don't profess to know who is right and who is wrong in the work stoppage, but we do urge all the parties concerned to sit down and work this one out. Here's a project in which the whole community has a stake. Let's get it completed on schedule. And we'll see you tonight at 11 o'clock on our next news report.
This has been Take 4, Channel 4's commentary on the day's news and close-up on the people who make it, with News Director Dave Murray. Tune in again at 7 o'clock tomorrow night for all the news on WTAE.